The Hungarian free bread is still with us. And I still don't know what it is. We never got the answer.
Beautiful morning here in Raiano in Italy. We're here at ACME recording studio and it's time for the first day of tracking drums. Really looking forward to it. We're gonna start this day, well it's almost 9 a.m. right now. We're gonna start today with just picking out all the drums, basically setting everything up. So today is preparation day, you know, setting the kit up, tuning, mic selection, head selection, all of that good stuff. But tomorrow starts like the real recording, but today is all about the preparation and setup. So personally, that's my favorite part of the whole thing, is to set the kit up, tune it, pick heads, you know, put on cymbals and everything. So it's gonna be fun.
Which one we used for the previous album with Max?
I think this one. But I don't remember. Now I go to see the picture.
Okay. All right, so the first step is to change the drum heads. We have new heads for all the toms and for the bass drum and also for the snares, which we will be trying later. So we'll start by changing heads. I think I'll start with the bass drum and move up in sizes to get the most bottom end. I find it easier to start with the you know, floor tom and bass drum first and then move up to get the right pitches. And once we've done that and set the whole kit up and sort of see that the kit itself works in tuning, then we'll try the different snares and change the heads with those and experiment just to see which snare goes best with the kit. Because, you know, if you listen to them separately, you know, one might sound better, but as soon as you put them with the kit, it's a whole different thing. It all has to blend together. All right, so now I've set up the toms and the bass drum, and I've done some basic tuning to everything. And to me, it sounds pretty good. We'll probably have to do some fine adjustments, make sure that everything works well together and that we get the desired sound once we actually put mics on these drums. But it's a pretty good start, and the studio was kind enough to let me choose which heads I wanted for the toms. So naturally, I picked the ones that I'm used to using on my own drum kit, which is the Evans G2 coated on the rack toms and the Evans EC2S frosted on the floor tom. We turned the drums around, so the bass drum is pointing towards these two mics over here, and then set up everything around that. So I'm gonna put up my cymbals and everything, and then we will try out the snares when I'm comfortable with the whole setup. So right now it's the Sonor Danny Carey signature snare there. I just put it there to have something to start with. Sounds killer, but we'll see which one it ends up being. All right, so now the kit is all set up, all the cymbals are in place, and everything that's left to do now is to try the different snare drums and put on some mics. So right now I've set everything to be comfortable for me to play with, but I've thought a little bit about, you know, where the mics are going to be. So like my hi-hats, I try to keep them kind of far away from the snare. Usually I might have them a little closer, but since we're going to record, I don't want too much of them bleeding into the snare mic. So I try to create some distance here, but still want it to be comfortable, you know. And yeah, basically set everything up. I also try to not let any of the stands touch each other, because like say for this stack here, which is kind of tight, when I hit it the stand moves. So if the stand touches something else down here, then it might create, like say touches the ride stand, and it might make the ride start going, you know. So anything to make it sound as clean as possible. And you can also see I mounted the ride from above here because there wasn't enough space underneath without the cymbals touching the stamps and stuff. So yeah, I try to keep everything clean but still comfortable, and I try to be, you know, adjustable. So now that we're gonna put mics on eventually, you know, if we need to change some heights and stuff, I'll be okay with it, because, you know, the recording goes first, but still it needs to be comfortable. So you need to find some sort of middle ground. But this is a good start foundation for all of this. So now let's experiment with some snares and fine tune some tuning perhaps when we put some mics on, and hopefully everything will sound great out there in the monitor room. All right, so now the mic setup is pretty much done. We've set all the mics up that we think we will be needing. The kit sounds really good right now acoustically, but you know, as soon as you put mics up like really close to the drums, it sounds a whole lot different. A kit sounds very different a couple of meters away compared to a couple of inches away, you know. So we're taking a little break, and we're gonna get going again soon. Put the cables in, record something, and see how it sounds. Mr. Light Guy, Ivan.
Yeah. In
sandals. Yeah, we just finished today. I think we're done. We set everything up, found a good drum sound, and it's pretty much done for starting recording tomorrow. So we had a lot of trouble with getting just the right amount of ring from the snare, but in the end, it turned out pretty good, so we'll see tomorrow. It might do some small adjustments, but overall it's good. We took some photos and stuff, so we'll see. It's gonna be cool.
Hi guys.
Food,
finally. Oh yeah.
You speak on Russians again.
Yeah, stupid Russians. You never shut up.
Always got something to say.
Yeah.
You know this Russian.
Gurdy. Ja, jag kan prata svenska, ni kommer inte fatta någonting av vad jag säger.
Okej, harkla.
Ja, känns det bra eller? Känns det bra eller?
Napravo.
Napravo. Känns det bra nu när ni inte fattar något vad jag säger? Det är liksom, det är lite samma grej. Jag har suttit i bil med er i 3 dagar och inte fattat någonting. Ja. It is now 2:50 p.m. We've spent pretty much the entire morning and the entire day so far adjusting and tuning and fixing the damn toms. It's like for some reason there was too much resonance all the time. If we got the good pitch that we wanted, the toms just sang forever. They wouldn't shut up and they blurred out the whole mix. It was just a lot of headache and a lot of work, but the drums sound really good now. So what we're doing is we're recording. The album is pretty much one long song. So it's 8 main tracks, around 2-3 minutes each. And between almost each track, there is a little break, a little like mini song between them. Anything between 10 seconds and 40 seconds. So it's basically 15 songs, but you know, they're super short. So we record from start to finish, all of them all the way through. And that's one take. And then we do that 3 times, take the best parts from the 3, put them together for a 4th take, which will hopefully be the final, and if there's small stuff to adjust, we'll fix it afterwards.
In America Latina, with...
three takes are done, we decided to scrap the first one because I didn't feel comfortable with it at all. So it's it was more of a warm up than anything else. So we have two good playthroughs. We'll play everything through one more time. That's three total, and then we'll start walking through it all, piecing together the good parts. I'll have a piece of paper to write all the good parts, all the bad parts, and we'll work through it, piece it together, and see what's left to record and fix. So we'll see how it goes. We're gonna start again in just a second. Today's day three, final day of tracking drums here in the studio. We will pick up where we left off yesterday with editing together all the takes, and then we'll basically see which gaps we need to fill, and we will go back into the drum room, record those tricky fills, those tricky parts, solos and stuff, over and over until we get that perfect take, just to fill in the gaps, fill in the blanks, and eventually we will have the complete drum track for the whole album, and we will be good to go and to move on to bass. So we're hoping to be done by like 6 or 7 p.m. tonight.
Like 6 or 7 p.m. tonight.
So it's going to be a good day of recording drums. The last day. It's kind of sad, but after that, my job here is done. And it's up to the rest of the guys to do their part. So yeah, let's get going again.
Very small red dot and one very small red dot. And then it's... but now it's going back.
Yeah.
It's better. That it's a little fast, but it works.
For now,
yeah.
It's okay.
So I would want that to be choked there, stopped. That because that's where you know, dun 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 dun, psht, and then it's only guitar.
Yeah.
But if it rings, it's not the same effect. So then it's, you know, re-record just that one, and, you know, or it's not, because it needs to be quiet for the guitar. Yeah. I don't even know what I'm playing there. Like, I don't think I can slow it down. It's just that... But it works.
AK-47.
Yeah. Feel is perfect. Timing is great, you know. classic disco feel.
Ты знал, что типа такое прикольное, вот типа что-то вроде этого.
Always, always, always.
Prego.
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 Prego, signor.
Repeat, prego.
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 I'm prego.
You're prego. Everyone prego.
Safely of Ukraine, some like a soldier.
Like a soldier.
You know.
Okay, rule number one of recording in the studio is to realize you will be optimistic about time. It's now, what time is it? It's 6:40 p.m. and we're long away from done. We expected to be done with the drums, like 100% finished by now.
Like 6 or 7 p.m. tonight.
But we're not going to be done until tomorrow, definitely. We need half of the day tomorrow too. We just finished editing all the songs, finding all the parts that we need to fix. So now we have a little list of the timestamps with which parts to fix. And also there's one more song, the first song of the album, that we haven't recorded at all because the setup is a little different. I need to change my stack into a China, just a standalone China, for that song. So we still have a bit of work to record. Maybe for the next 2 hours or so we will record and then piece everything together. And then David, the studio owner, has to sit and edit small stuff for many, many hours to fix the whole, like all the small minor details that make the big difference for the whole album. And then after that, we're pretty much done. So it's going to be a long night and probably we'll have to work a bit tomorrow morning before lunch too. But then hopefully around lunchtime afternoon, we'll be 100% done with drums.
Hopefully around lunchtime afternoon.
So, exhausting. I'm getting a headache. Everyone's getting a headache, but it's getting there.
I'm a fool by the clay, so if you not afraid, homie, you not afraid, it's the death of them. Fall back like a rewind. I'm busy shooting while you fighting for the screen time. I'm really cool with David Venice in this green time.
Book.
Grazie.
Everyone's tired. It's 10 past 12. No, now I'm happy. I am 100% happy.
I want one more thing.
100% happy.
Impossible. Impossible.
Are you?
Me?
Yeah.
3%.
Three.
Three. from 100?
From 100.
That's bad.
For me, three is bad. It's good. Very good.
How am I?
Usually it's two. Two. Yeah, now it's three.
Sorry?
Usually it's two, but now it's three, right?
Yeah. Usually, minor.
Minus.
Minus four.
Oh, well, that's.
I'm pessimist.
At least it's more than zero, right?
Yeah.
I take it as a compliment.
For me, three. Bomba.
So drums are done?
Drums are done.
Morning?
Yeah, it's different, but good morning. I don't like it. Use
volume knob because.
Alright, we are officially finished with drums, so now it's just time to pack everything down. I'll put my cymbals back in the case and all my stuff, and we'll remove the new heads we put on the drums and put back the old ones because we rented the kit from a friend of the studio owner. This one too.
But I don't know where to. Like here?
Here, I guess?
Add the date, please.
The date? Okay. What date is it? What date is it?
It's 22 July.
Nice.
With a little... Perfect.
I think you actually need a chainsaw. Anyway.
I wouldn't mind if I were.
But is it old? So that's why it's like
no,
hard?
It's
new?
It's new like that.
Thank you.
So finally, everything's done with the drums. We've had a really good couple of days setting up, recording, trying different things, and the end result, I think, is really good. The drums sound great, like they are now, and I can't wait to hear them finished in the album, mixed, mastered, and everything. It's gonna be really cool. And for me, it's the first time recording drums for a full album like this in a studio. So it's been a really cool and rewarding experience. And just the fact that I was able to come all the way from Sweden to Ukraine to rehearse, to Italy to record an album for a band that I met online like a year ago, it's a really cool experience. I don't know what I can say. I've had a blast. Book, be quiet. I've had a blast, and I can't wait to do more things with these guys. We'll see what the future holds, but for now I'm super excited to wait and see how the full album turns out. On Sunday we have a day off, we'll head into Rome, and that's where I'll take my flight back home to Sweden, and the other guys will stay to finish up the album the next week. So thank you everyone who watched this little vlog, documentary, whatever you want to call it. Thanks for tuning in and checking out what I've been up to for the last week or 2 weeks or whatever. I'll see you guys again soon. I'll let you know when when the album is available, so you can hear the finished results. I'll try to post it somewhere, everywhere, so you can hear what it sounds like. All right, take care, guys.
Just to get there.